God damn it. Keep that for self-defense. Even though we're not risking of losing anytime soon. You wanna protect those coins? That is also one of my favorite races in the game. I think I'll move my Switch closer. I seem to have some problem with my joystick, my freaking left Joy-Con thing. I didn't have any problem when playing Zelda last month, but like, it's not too apparent. Sometimes I do have problem when racing. So far, it's never been in terrible moments. Could become annoying. Anyway, after this cup I'll try the online mode. I'm really curious about it. Square Enix. Hopefully bringing this Switch console closer will help with the control issues. That race looks nice, but I don't like it that much. Like, I wouldn't say I don't like it, just more like it's one of my weaker races. I'm in the air! Okay, good, we landed. That's the most important thing. At least we landed, I guess. Oh my god, please! I wanna keep my freaking coins. Alright, we got back to 10, so that's good. Alright, let's try online. Oh wait, no, that's multiplayer. Yay, random! Explosion! Really, of all the time, it's now that the blue shell appears when I'm first. Wow, fuck you guys! I was holding for the red shell and never appeared in my butt. God damn it. All that work to get back to first place and it only lasted 5 seconds. Oh, that was still fun. Like, there's no reason to get mad at the Mario Kart game. Alright, one more that will go back to doing some comps. I like that one. Oh, it even shows you who won the last race. At least, I believe that's what it is. Hooray! Plus, we had 0 coins at the end of the race. Feels bad. Oh. Well, why not? What? To the other user's console. Okay. I basically only took my character. Like, I didn't even start to search for players. I feel like it was me, actually. Oh well. Happens. We're going to wait after a race to be finished. Well, the race is over! Okay, screw online. My Switch might have some connection trouble. That will not stop us from doing some cups. Alright, let's go drive over. Fun fact, Bowser is one of my favorite characters in Mario Kart. Just not necessarily good, but I like playing as him. Like, when Mario Kart 8 came out, I did the whole game with Bowser, and then they released 200cc. I could not do it with Bowser. That's why I changed to Villager. I would play Waluigi from time to time also, like, I really like playing him. But the heavyweights, like, I really enjoy playing them, they're just hard to play. And you need a bit of luck. Because, like, you can't reach maximum speed. Like, it takes a long time to get maximum speed. But once you get there, like, nobody will ever catch up to you. But the thing is that, with all the items, it's kind of easy to lose speed there and there. So that's why I say you need a bit of luck to play those. Even back from Mario Kart 64, I would play Bowser. Strictly Bowser, I wouldn't play anyone else. Heck, even at work today? I was waiting, I had nothing to do. Like, I was just waiting, because I was in a replacement shift and nobody needed me, so I had to wait for 3 hours, and recently we got a N64 in the cafeteria. So I was playing Mario Kart 64 for most of the day, waiting for the shift to be over so I could go play Mario Kart 8 Deluxe! Fun fact, not fun fact, fun story, that's more like it. Anyways, while I was playing Mario Kart 64 at work, another one that was in replacement, he brought his Switch and was playing Mario Kart 8. I wanted so bad to play with him that I didn't dare to ask. I think the plane made me go downwards a bit. I'm not sure on that. That really felt wrong to go that low. That was weird. Anyways, we won. That is definitely one of my weakest maps. By far. I don't remember every race in the game, but this is one of my weakest. If it is not the weakest. Like, I know plenty of tricks to get lots of speed boosts, like here. But even then, like, the movement in the water feels weird. Like, I don't know. I'm not saying it's bad, it's just like I have trouble playing optimally. Especially I have a hard time getting 10 freaking coins! Oh my god, stop hitting me, guys! I need my coins! How will that play out? Okay, I fall. That's fine, I guess. This is not going well, guys. Use it. I really wanted those coins. God damn it. I tried to go on the right side. I always go like right in the middle. So maybe the side. The paths on the side are faster, I don't know. Maybe that's what I'm lagging, because I always go in the center where there's like 3 windpipe, so I can get 3 boosts. Because it's in the middle, so I don't have to turn around or something. Oh my god, they're annoying. Oh my god, really? Another one for the roll, please? Fucking Mark, man. shouldn't be. It's possible. That shouldn't be. Like, is it? Oh, I just noticed. Apparently I do. Thing is that I can't really go lower because I think it'll be freaking ugly. It's only for now anyways, like I'm getting a new computer real soon that should help a lot with streaming quality. But outside of that, hey Ryu, how are you doing? And we continue where we left off with more red shells thrown at us. But I do not seem to be dropping that. Wow, they're on to me. I do not seem to be dropping that much frame. I did see at one point I dropped a few, but overall it doesn't seem too terrible. Like, I feel like it's totally bearable. Totally. But this is something like it will definitely be a focus for me. I'm like, like in 2 days I'm supposed to go somewhere to check for a new computer and even possibly make it build. Yeah, and I'm going to drop kind of a lot of money on it because I mean, oh my god, stop it, computers! Holy shit, things right behind me. So yeah, I definitely want a high quality computer that will help me with doing a lot of stuff. Cause this computer is kind of old right now. This is a joke. Oh my! No, no, wow. Really? I've been robbed. I've been fucking robbed of my 3-star rating. That was a complete robbery. Wow. I'm on 50 CC and I got destroyed. Wow, I've been robbed. I'll have to do that again. I don't accept it. We'll finish it. We'll come back to it. I'm blaming Dry Bowser. When you're a skeleton, you cannot have any luck at all. Or something, I don't know. As far as I know, there's no luck stats in this game. Because I remember Mario Kart DS had that stats. Where I think it helped with the quality of items you would be receiving. But I think they dropped it right after. Maybe it's some Mario Kart Wii, I can't remember. The game was just okay. But okay, I mean, it was still good, but like, it was one of the weaker title games in the series. Alright, we're not going there yet. Hello, Apple. It has been a while, yes. How are you doing today? I'm doing fine, thank you for asking. Oh. I'm happy to say that. I want to come back to streaming like more regularly. Like I couldn't stream a lot for the past almost 2 years, so I just didn't bother and tried YouTube stuff and didn't like it and decided that I really want to come back to streaming. Although I don't think I'll come back to speedrunning. Like I might do casual speedrun, but like grinding, serious grinding, I don't think so. But other than that, I just want to stream. Like it's fun. I enjoy talking with the viewers, and yeah, just fun. I don't know. All right, let's go back to this. Like. I don't agree with that, what happened. What happened in Electrodome? I don't agree, but I'll be back. I'll be right back. Alright, let's continue. Well, I only speedrun for 3 years, about 2 or 3 years, something like that. Yeah, 2 years would make sense. Anyways, and I enjoyed it. It just, as it goes on, the game that you constantly grind feels like a chore, and that's when I started to not have fun. I really wanted to get my goals, like sub 2 hours for DKC3 and something good for DKC2. I can't remember, like 132 or something. But yeah, I just couldn't take it anymore. Sadly. I still love those games. I'll definitely stream them again because they're about my favorite games of all time. But I needed a break. I definitely need a break. Like, I felt like I was close to just hating those games forever. And I didn't want that. I'd rather just play whatever feels like. Whatever I feel like I want to play. Like, right now I feel like playing Mario Kart 8, I'm playing Mario Kart 8. Honest, I want to play some playthroughs and stuff like that. Some online game. And me getting destroyed by Rich Hells also, like, that's definitely something I wanted to stream, but... but yeah, just being carefree or something like that. Oh no, stole my banana, I don't care. Aw, I missed it. I wanted that mushroom. Oh, the boo actually steal your current item. Like, I was holding the banana right behind me. And he still stole it, that's really interesting. Oh, thank you for your support, Apple. You don't have to if you don't feel like it, but if you enjoy it, then it's my pleasure to bring you an enjoyable experience. And thank you. Oh, we're still winning. That's what we need. We need to win. I didn't lose my drift. Which zones are you in? Like, are you from Europe? I'm sorry for asking, like, I must have forgotten, and my apologies for that. I can't remember if it's Europe or West Coast or somewhere else. I feel bad, sorry. Thank you. Well, don't worry, because to be honest, if I stream during the week, like right now, it's possible for me to stream about any time. Well, not really any time, but like it's really flexible right now. But once work starts getting back like full time, I might not be able to stream much during the week. My plan will most likely be weekends. Like during the week, I will stream, but it will be for evening for me, which is like East Coast of America. So if you're Europe, well, I won't be able to stream at an appropriate time for you. But during the weekends, like, I could stream at any time. I just thought of something. Boo can sell your currently selected item. Even if it's out, I would assume, like, the three bananas that are rotating around the character. I would assume he can steal them. If he does he get all banana all the time, or just the remaining? Because let's say you use two of them and you keep the last one, and Boo comes and steal your item. Does he get all three of the bananas, or does he only get the remaining one? That could be worth checking into. We're trying to develop the meta of the game. All right, time to get our revenge on that stage. Yeah, that seems like a good time for you. Definitely. Thing is that I don't know this summer what time I'll be working. Like, we have like three different work shifts. 7 a.m., 9 a.m., and 3 p.m. If I work at 3 p.m., I could stream beforehand, before that. He had to steal my green shell before getting hit by the red shell. Freaking weird. Anyway, yeah, like if I work evening shift, I'll be able to stream before that. And if I work morning shift, well, I have to stream after that, obviously. And weekends, well, it's like I said, it will be about anytime I want and can. Well, nice, we skipped the red shell somehow. We're taking that. So far this is going good. As long as you don't receive 7 items in a row, we should have this. Oh my god, are you for real? Are you for real? I saw the blue shell coming, and as I pressed to use my super horn, the fucking thunder removed the super horn from me, and I have to take the blue shell in the face. Wow. Game, you really don't want me to win, right? I don't know if they tweaked with the item chances of appearing, but they must have to some point, because I can't remember if the bombs were already in the game before, but the boo was not, and that's a new item. Plus, you can have two items at the same time, so I feel like they tweaked the chances of getting items for every item, so it's different or something. Mine might not be that different, but it needs to be simply because of new items in the game. And by new items, I really mean the blue at least. Like, maybe the bottom as well, that one I'm really not sure. And I know there's a feather, but that's only in battle mode, I think. Which I'll have to try, to be honest. I've never been a fan of battle mode, to be honest. But doesn't mean we shouldn't try it. When I think back about it, battle mode, I like it in teams. Like, in team, it can be really fun. In free-for-all, I'm not a fan. Yeah! That feels so good. When you destroy that blue shell with a super horn, that feels so good. One of the best feelings in a Mario Kart game ever. And when you get denied that by a thunder like it happened earlier, it's one of the worst feelings. You just feel you got robbed. Robbed of that precious protection. I used my green shot. I didn't want to do that. Yeah, I did for sure. I lost it, and by a landslide. Like, I think the record is 156 something right now. 156, that's freaking crazy. Like, I was always saying 157 will be possible. It will be hard, but it will be possible. And not a lot of people believed it. Most of people were saying 158 will be the limit. And someone got 156. Like, that's crazy. And I think 4 or 5 people got sub 2 hours. Like, I kept saying it's not that hard to get sub 2 hours. You just need to perform. But yeah, like, I'm not surprised I lost it, to be honest. Like, I kept saying it's not that hard. I was still, that might feel like, I don't know, I'm being selfish a bit, but I'm still proud of having, of holding that world record for a long time. I think 1 year or two, I can't remember exactly how long. I am still proud of that. Like, it's easily my best accomplishment in speedrun that I've ever done. And I feel like I helped also a lot in developing the meta of DKC3. But now the meta is much farther than where it was, and that is with the help of a lot of people, like I think Claude, Void, all the people that got sub 2 hours, Raikou, Antilles, whatever. It's not only about one person, it's about the whole community working together to make something amazing happen. It might have been 2 years, like it's either one or two, I can't remember exactly. Anyway, let's play with Inkling Boys this time. But yeah, that was an amazing experience. Like, that was fun. Like, speedrunning, I wouldn't say it changed much of. Yes, it did. It changed how I view gaming in general. And it also helps me in my work, because I work as a QA tester for video games right now, and it helps a lot, because I can think of stuff that could potentially be a bug that no other can, because they don't have the speedrunning experience. And it's really fun in those cases when I find something really awkward in the game that can potentially break it or something like that. Like, it's really amazing. It doesn't happen often, but when it does, I feel so good. Like, I've done something great, I know I've been helpful or something, it's hard to say that. Like, I've done my job, basically. Like, for some people it's easy to enter a lot of bugs, like, some will enter a crap ton of bugs. But like, most of them are like, graphical issues. Personally, I have trouble with graphical issues unless it's really apparent, because like, because I'm like, well, is that intended or not? I don't know. But gameplay bugs, I can easily identify them because of my speedrunning background. And I feel like that is really helping me. So you never know, doing anything gaming related can help you in so many ways in life that you wouldn't even think of. And it's really fun. So far so good. I never played that game. Is it like a regular platformer, or is there some gimmicks to it? I see. And is a run long? Like, how long is a run? In on average, let's say on average, how long is a run? Damn, that's a long platformer. Honestly, I was expecting something like under 30 minutes. But keep at it. As long as you're having fun, keep at it. Do you have a goal that you want to attain? Like a short-term goal. Damn. That's a really short time. Is it because you just started to run the game basically? Or is the run like particularly hard or anything like that? I'm just wondering because you can do it. If you put in the effort, you can do it. Anyone can do anything as long as you put in the effort. It's all in the practice, the effort, and everything. It's highly optimized. Alright. Can't see that. Short runs, and by short I mean sub 1 hour, most of the time it's optimized to the point where saving 1 second is like a huge deal or something. I said sub 1 hour, but even like 1 hour 30 sometimes can be exceptionally optimized. Like, look at Zelda A Link to the Past. Holy crap, that game is optimized. And it's freaking crazy. When you say no mistake, do you mean like no apparent mistake? Because I refuse to believe that anyone is without mistake. Like, even if they're almost invisible to the eye. Like, there's always improvement somewhere in others. Although sometimes it just creates... It's almost nothing to... It's almost impossible to really improve. Like, you look at Super Mario Bros. 1, and... They only improve the time by, like... tens of seconds. It's like, what? I see, so... So from what I'm telling you, if I get this correctly, the game, the run is not hard itself, but doing a mistake would cost you the whole run, right? Because that mistake will make you lose your jetpack. Or something like that. Am I getting this right? Alright. Is there any part in the run where... Like, this one segment? You're like, shit, I might lose my jetpack half the time or something like that. Because it's like the hardest part in the game to lose your jet. The easiest part in the game to lose your jetpack. Is there any part of that run where it's like that? And is it far in the run? If you lose the power up, you're too slow. So it basically makes your general movement faster? Is that what it does? Or is it because you're you can skip some platforms and just move faster, or you get to secret areas? I'm asking, I don't know the game, but let's try battle mode. Because why not? Let's do 1 or 2. Where's Bowser? Oh, there it is. I see ya. Alright, apparently we are spectating, so we're going to see how battle mode goes. But I would think that there's no team in regular battle mode. Oh, I assume it's only free for all, like races are. I mean, race is better free for all in my opinion, but team races is pretty fun as well. I haven't done a lot, but I thought it was pretty fun. Communication error. God damn it. I don't know if it's my Switch that has problem connecting to my router. Whatever. Let's do some more Grand Prix. Okay, so you get it pretty early, okay. Triforce tires. I think they put the... all the DLC cart that you get as unlockable. That's nice. If that's the case, I think that's pretty nice. Yeah, let's go with the egg cup. Oops, I didn't want to send it forward. Wait, am I catching up to those in the back of the of everyone? I love it when I do that. Oh no, you're not getting away from me. Here, grab a banana. Don't hit me, don't hit me, don't hit me, don't hit me. I'm your friend, I'm not your enemy. Don't hit me. I feel like deathless runs are like the worst. Because you're like, yeah, I finally managed to get a deathless run. But I need to improve on that. Crap! Because a death is ultimately a huge place to save time. And when you don't die, well, where's the next biggest place that you can save time? I don't know. It depends on the game, but yeah, most of the time with death is like death chest runs, I feel like, are so stressful to run again. And even if you get a better run, like let's say you beat your PB but you die twice, you'll feel so bad about it because you were like, dang it, I got a PB, I died twice. My previous PB, I didn't die once. Like, what the fuck is going on? And it feels so bad. Also, the world record was with major skips, and your run was with no skips. Okay. So the no major skip runs is about 38 minutes long. Is that what you're telling me? Will you try to go for a major skip run, or you will continue with the no major skip? That's fair enough. Well, in any cases, I wish you luck on all your future attempts, and hopefully you'll be happy and satisfied with whatever PB you end up getting in the end. Is all treasures like 100%? Is it much longer than the regular run? Pardon me. The game also has different endings, and what are the requirements for the endings, if I may ask? Is that a lot? Is 20,000 coins a lot? It seems like it is, but I just want to make sure. I see. So I assume that you need, like, to grind, farm. You need to farm coins at one point and or another in the run, I assume. I think I just remembered something. I think the energy pad gives coins, right? On the F-Zero tracks. I'm not sure. Because there's no coin on the tracks. That would make sense. Let's try that. Yes, exactly. Okay, that's how you get coins. So at first everyone jumps on those tracks and then try to keep their coins as much as possible. That makes a ton of sense now. Is it a long farming session? Like, do you need to grind for like 30 minutes to get all the coins, or like less than that or something? So many coins. Oh well. Damn, over 2 hours, that's pretty long. which character? King Boo. What do you mean by a casual run? Like an any percent run? Or just like, you just play the game normally and you get around that number? Oh my god, I just realized it's the baby part. With double item? Holy shit, that's going to be chaotic. Good thing is the first race of the car. Although saying that, not liking that this race is not true. I love that race because of the chaotic nature of it. I got first. Alright, so in casual playthrough, it's not too bad. If you get 9,000 just playing the game, like, seems fair. Maybe slightly on the low side, but let's not nitpick. It's still okay. I mean, it's almost half of them, so it's not too bad. Wow, he managed to hit me with that fresh shell when I had three banana turning around me. I'm calling... That's a... He was cheating. There's no way. Nah, for real. It's not like it's impossible. It's just highly improbable that this thing will happen. Oh. So if you go for 100%, like, I mean, all treasures, you get even more coins. So you're almost at the 20,000, right? When you get all the treasures, I would assume. It's pretty good then. Yeah, that's pretty good. I thought at first I thought like good ending would be like super long compared to all treasures just because of those coins, but if it's only a bit more, it's not too long. Six? Damn. All that for a Wario game. Okay, call me impressed here. Like, I would never expect that. When you said best ending, I was like, okay, there's two endings. That's it. There can't be any more than two endings. And then you are, well, there's six endings in the game. I'm like, what the fuck? Then six ending. Usually when there's multiple endings, it's, well, it's an RPG. Is there any missable items or treasures in the game, or you can always go back and find them? Yeah, I am assuming that that some items may be, that some treasures may be well hidden. Thank you. Let's go Leaf Town. I like that map. One thing I don't know is if it plays differently on different seasons, because you can load the map on 4 different seasons. And I just don't know if it changes anything in the race. I don't remember, and even then I wasn't even sure of that. Like, is it icier on winter? I can't remember. I just felt like it was fun to have a race that has different visual. Right now I am assuming I'm in fall and there wouldn't be apple anywhere on any other season, so okay, there might be differences. That's nice. Wait, if we were in fall, it would be like the trees would be like red, right? The leaves in the tree would be red. Oh no, that's summer. It just feels weird to have fruits on the floor when it's not fall. I might be wrong, anyway. Let's continue this. Halfway done with 50cc. I mean, I know it is slow for now because 50cc is the easiest and slowest speed, but I really want to get everything done. So let's get everything done by starting by the most boring thing. Besides, at the same time, I haven't played in a while. It helps get back in it, you know? never get to 200cc. I almost never played it, to be honest. Like, I did every cup on the 150 and mirror cup, but never got around to do 200cc's completely. Shell Cup. Let's go. Let's go for more retro tracks. I like playing as Inky Girl. I thought it would be weird to have those characters from Splatoon in the game, but that's how they make it cute, so like, okay, you guys fit in, you're alright. I have to make sure, but I think they're medium weight, which is like the same as Villager, which is basically the character I use most. So yeah, that's good for me. That was like really close to hitting me. In your face, Yoshi! Oh! try to hit Waluigi before I get exploded by the blue shell. Coins respawns a lot faster, I thought it would. You blue shell, you won't hit me this time. Oops. Welcome back, Mister. Oh, that was close. Almost hit the back of that truck. Amen. again on that truck. Yeah. Because I wanted to fly for a bit. There's absolutely no reason to do that. I feel like the best way to play this race is to ride the walls on the outside. Like, sure, playing on the inside might be faster. But I don't know. It's not because it's safer. It feels more consistent to play on those walls. Like, you get boost all along, and yeah, it's not that long. While as if you play right on the road, you have to zigzag through the cars. Which can make you lose time. Of course you can drift and get massive speed like this, but it's not as constant. I like destroying the cars like this. So I don't know, I feel like it's really a matter of preference here. This race. God damn. Oh, that was the last one. I thought there was another one. I keep forgetting which race I'm on. Does it show how many coins I have? 289, nice. Mini Turbo, Support Mini Turbo, and Ultra Mini Turbo? Why the hell is an Ultra Mini Turbo? I'm legit confused here. Alright, take care. Hope you enjoyed. And have a good night, since I'm going to assume that you're going to bed soon enough. So, good night. 'Continue drifting, the blue spark would turn orange and then become purple. Okay, so you get a mini turbo for the blue one. You get a super mini turbo for the orange one. And then you have a purple one, which is the ultra mini turbo. Holy shit, I'm fairly certain this was not in the game back on Wii U. Call me surprised here. But you must have... You have to drift for so long. Damn. That's nice. check out some more stuff. Okay, let's do one more cut, then we'll stop for now. Okay, it will soon be time to eat and... yeah. Who do I pick? Let's go with Daisy. Beep, 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 beep. Of course, in the very moment I decided to just throw my shell. Oh yeah, I remember that race. A lot of my friends hated it. When it's not too bad. It can be pretty harsh, but it's not that bad of a race actually. Might be a you look at it, it looks simple, but it's a little bit more technical than it seems to be. Because there's a lot of sharp turns. I mean, of course at 50cc it's not really important. As soon as you get to 150cc, the turns are pretty hard to get. I feel like this race on 150 is like an excellent entry point for 200cc. Because you need to learn to brake during drifting, and in the turns are so sharp in this race that, yeah. It's a good race to learn that. It's not like it's particularly hard, but you need to get the mindset to do it and just to press the brake just a little bit and basically tap the button to get the desired effect of sharp turning. But that's only after 150cc. Like, on 150 I feel like it's not that necessary. Although some races it's definitely useful. Like this one for example. But for 200cc you need it on about everywhere. I'm the best. Coins. That's all I care about, my coins. I should play as Wario. That's for a long time actually. Damn. It is hard to get, but this this changes a lot in the strategy of this game. That's really nice. Like, I was used to, like, you get the second park and you just release it and start another one right away. With the third mini turbo introduced, I have to get used to actually waiting for it before starting another spark. And that's not everywhere that you'll be able to use it, obviously. Because you have to charge it for a pretty long time. Really interesting. I think I timed it perfectly. I used my 2 coins as I was getting hit. So instead of losing 3 coins, I only lost 1. I didn't know if it was possible. Apparently it is.
DK Donkey Kong.
Got that not.
First of all, because I'm a huge Donkey Kong fan, and second of all, then I've been really good.
I thought he would jump without getting to the frog. It didn't. Oh well. That'll teach me for trusting movable objects. I also like to play as Daisy. Oh my god, please. Mainly because in Double Dash, I would use her along with maybe Bowser. I thought it was a really good team. Like, I get the ultimate defense with Daisy's heart, and then I would get the ultimate attack with maybe Bowser's carapace? Carapace? Shell. Bowser shell. That was just so good. Plus, I would get my friend crazy because Daisy's kind of retarded in Double Dash. Like, she has to yell, "I am Daisy!" all the freaking time. She's like, yeah, she has some kind of mental disorder or something like that. It's like everyone has to know that she is Daisy. Show coming up. Oh yeah. We good. We good. Alright, that will be it for now. Most likely be back later, like in 2 hours maybe? I don't know, I'll be back tonight for more Mario Kart or maybe other games. We'll see. But yeah, I like it so far. It's really fun. Hope you guys enjoyed it also. And we'll see you another time.